Dustin Reynolds.
Maddie, and that's Serrano. And we're doing a winged documentary about anything we wanted, and we chose the part.
That's awesome.
How and why did you want to start this business?
How and why? So I'd always been in food service here and there. I went to school for art, but I always wanted to be a teacher. So that may not have lined up exactly how college should have lined up. But so I had a dream that maybe like one day I would have a little bakery or a cafe, probably in Boston where I was for a long time. But this sort of came up accidentally. Francine, who had been the owner here for 27 years before I had, and who I grew up getting to eat her yummy treats, she broke her decorating arms, like her right arm, and she couldn't do any of her cakes in May of 2020. It came up accidentally, and I said, this sounds perfect, I'll do it. And I think that's a good advice to sometimes take opportunities if it feels right.
I'm eating a mixed berry muffin. It's even so warm. I'm having an iced coffee. A solid 10 for the muffin, 8.5 for the coffee. I just prefer French vanilla over hazelnut.
So we heard you were on a baking show, so how did you get on?
That is a good question. I had applied for many, many years, probably 10 to 12 years for different cooking shows. And I really thought I was gonna get on some of them, and then I didn't get on. I'd be flown to New York or to LA and I'd have these final interviews. And one year I was like an alternate, so I'd have my bags packed just in case something happened to somebody or they couldn't come to filming. And you know, even till the last minute of the filming, I was supposed to be there just in case they had to start over. And so I really thought one of these years I'm gonna get on. Then nothing happened. Then during COVID, I was supposed to be on a different show, and I forget exactly what happened, but it was a show called Bakeaway Camp, hosted by Martha Stewart on her property, which would have been probably my dream show to be on. But we didn't really know what was happening or who was in charge of it. Oh, I think they changed the filming dates, and it would have been while I was teaching. And so we were able to come back during COVID to teach in person. And so I wasn't able to do that, but I had been assigned to that show. But then because that was done by Food Network kept me in the pile. They were like, we really like him, we need to find a place for him. And then the show came up through the same casting people, even though it was on a different channel. I sort of said, oh, I don't want to apply for this one. It doesn't seem like right up my alley, because it was a tribute to Julia Child, who I love. But I figured, you know, other people are probably bigger Julia Child fans than I am, and so let them have their opportunity. But I think that they really wanted someone who at the time was in Boston, who, like, I had met Julia Child in 2004 before she passed away. It didn't go how I wanted to. My lifelong fear is fish, like smelling them, touching them, being near them, seeing them in front of me. It like makes me physically sick. And the very, very first thing we had to cook with was fish. But the rest of the show didn't go exactly how I wanted to, because when it got to the baking part, I didn't get to do, you know, the thing that I know that I can do really well. But there were a lot of things kind of stacked against us, including time and how the set was built. There was air conditioners right above our ovens, so the ovens weren't quite working properly. But you know, at the end of the day, you can only take responsibility for yourself. So really, it was all on me. It was a nice, really positive thing, and I would definitely do it again.
Okay, so how many hours on average do you spend in
the day? So we get here at, oh gosh, anywhere between 4:30 and 6, depending on which day we're working, you know. And so that starts a minimum, you know, every morning is 1 hour to start with. Then we continue baking until about 10:30 or 11 when we, although usually there's one person still making something or making a dough or whatever. So I would say up to 12 hours in a day, all 6 days per week. So it does get a little wild, but that's part of our life. So it's just the cleanup we don't like to do. So, and that's in the kitchen too, but I think that's everybody's least favorite part.
How would you describe the feeling you have towards your business?
Oh, love, hate, I guess. No, I'm just teasing, sort of. They do say that when you own your own business, especially in food service, like if you're making food for people, you're like married to your job, basically. And so that is something I do think about, something where, I mean, we literally live next door. I just walked over here in like less than 1 minute. So that is very convenient, but we end up spending some more time here than I would normally probably like to. But I love it, and I love what we do, and I love that we're part of people's, you know, special occasions, and they're like happy moments. And so even if they like don't remember or don't know where the cake came from, I think that it's helpful to think, you know, that we're part of something usually happy.
Okay, so